Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. Welcome to the second video of the tutorial series covering our Inventor plugin. In the first video, we learn how to draw a path as a sketch, project it on a curved surface, and import the result as a robot path in RoboDK. This was a pretty quick way to create a polishing path for our canoe. It gave us the opportunity to use two options in our Inventor plugin, the load part option and the auto setup option. For this second tutorial, we will build this example, a robot removing excess material on a car rim, all that using a spindle and a turntable. First, we need to learn how to extract an edge from our part in Inventor and import it in RoboDK. It will be treated as a robot path and will give you a result similar to this one. I will then go one step further and I will show you how to consider the radius of your cutting tool in your cutting path. This usually requires the usage of a specialized CAM software, but for simple one-pass geometries, you can do a pretty good job only using Inventor. Okay, let's start that project. Okay, first we need to talk about my concept here. I want to remove the excess material from the inside edges of the rim. The green line represents the pattern I need to follow. Considering that it's a wheel, the pattern repeats itself. In this case, it repeats itself 6 times, so every 60 degrees. That means that if I do the exact same path, at the exact same place, while rotating the turntable by increment of 60 degrees, I will be able to complete my task. If I open the folder here, turntable position, you can find 6 targets. Each one representing one step of the rotation. As you can see, the path itself stays at the same place. By the way, I don't want to go too much into details about the turntable stuff, but I created the turntable myself using the model mechanism and robot module. It was greatly improved lately. You can now create new type of robots, gripper, and mixed external axis. Anyway, the point is that I will use the creation of the turntable as a subject for a future video. I will show you how to start from the 3D model, create the mechanism, record the positions, and create the movement subprograms. For this example, I will simply use the movement subprogram available here. Each one is simply a call to a move J and a position around the table. If I open the main program, you can see the list of subprogram calls. I start by calling the first turntable position, followed by the rim trimming program, followed by another turntable position, and so on and so on. Okay, now let's go through the path positioning. The path is in the path reference frame, obviously. So if we compare, the rim is part of the part reference frame, which is also attached to the turntable. Therefore, if I rotate the turntable, the part will follow, but the path will stay in place. Talking about the path, let's delete the one we have here and re-import it. Okay, let's go in Inventor. So here we have our rim. Like I said in the intro, we already seen the auto setup and load part option in the first tutorial. So this is covered. For this one, we will concentrate on the load curves feature. Activate it. I can now select the edges that will compose the path I need to follow. I'll choose these lines here, this one, and these lines here. So this one and this one. Once I got my lines, I could be tempted to simply click done and jump in RoboDK. But we still need to do one more step before that. We need to give some information to RoboDK for it to know the correct orientation of the cutting tool. In this situation, I want the cutting tool to be normal to the surface. For that, I simply need to select the top surface. I can then click Done, wait a bit, and switch to RoboDK. Now I need to align the path in front of the robot. I just need to rotate the path frame, so I'll move it by increment of 60 degrees. Okay, that's a good spot. Now, open your curve follow project. I will reduce the length of the approach and retract movements. 25 millimeters is enough here. I don't need more than that. Okay, Now click on Show Estimated Toolpath. At the moment, you see a bunch of tools along the path. These represent the orientation of the tool along that path. At the moment, there is a bit too much information for it to be very useful. I'll just put my mouse on top of the Show Estimated Toolpath, and I will hold Control, and I will use my scroll wheel downward. That will reduce the number of green tools. So, like I said, Control and scroll wheel down. I can keep only one if I want. Okay, this time I will stay at the same place, so on the Show Estimated Toolpath option, and I won't be pressing the Control key, and I'll simply use my scroll wheel to move the tool along the path. So I can move it forward, or I can move it backward. Pretty nice. I could change the orientation around Z, and see the difference in real time. So as you can see here, the tool is rotating while I'm changing the rotation around Z. Speaking of changing the orientation of the tool around Z, I will show you another little trick. If I grab my scroll bar here, and I bring the robot, let's say, near the middle of the path. Let's say that instead of wanting the robot arm on this side of the working station, I want it to be on the other side, so right here. So in fact, I simply need the tool to rotate around its Z-axis. Remember, the Z-axis is always the one coming out of the tool, so it's the blue arrow just right here. If I want, I can simply rotate the tool around its tooltips, something like that. Now I can click the Teach button, right here. It will record the new orientation of the tool around its Z-axis, and if I update and simulate the path, the rotation of the tool is now rotated, so it's cool. So now if I launch the main program, the cutting paths will be executed one after the other. So just like that. And obviously there's a rotation of the turntable between each execution. Okay, that's pretty cool. But if we go a bit closer, we can see that we are only cutting with the tip of the cutting tool. In this situation, we should remove some material using this section of the tool here. The problem right now is that the TCP of the tool is placed at the tip of it, so right here. So only the tip will follow the line. But if the TCP was here instead, we could cut with this section of the spinning tool. In that situation, we can press Alt and Shift and move the TCP. Here I will simply use the blue arrow to bring the TCP a bit upward. If you have questions about TCP modification or about the custom tool in general, we have video tutorials covering these topics on our YouTube channel. Now that the cutting length is set, I can update and simulate the new path. Okay, now everything looks good in terms of depth of cut. The problem now is that by lowering my cutting tool, I increased its radius. Therefore, I'm cutting too much material along the path and I need to fix this. Before telling you how you can do that, I need to tell you something. We are at the limit of what you can do simply with the 3D modeling software here. If you need to do a machining project more complex than that, let's say with multiple layers of material to remove, I will recommend you to generate your path with a machining software, commonly known as a CAM software, and simply import the path as a G-code file in RoboDK. RoboDK will then transform the G-code in a robot path and a robot program. You will have a much better result and a much better experience. But still, I will show you how you can do a pretty good job just with Inventor. I will delete our actual path and the curve follow project linked to it. Now in Inventor, I have another car rim here that I modified a bit. As you can see, I now have a yellow path that is offset from the edges. This way, the cutting tool will follow the path and cut the excess material along the surface. I won't show you in details how I created that path. I don't want this video becoming an Inventor modeling tutorial. I will simply give you the big steps. First, I created a 2D sketch on top of the rim, flat to this surface. Then I selected the edges here and there. I projected them on the 2D sketch. I used that 2D sketch to offset the line toward the inside of the pocket. Obviously, the offset length is the radius of the cutting tool. Then I needed to project this new 2D sketch on the rim surface. But the problem is that there was no surface underneath it. So to solve this problem, I created a sketch with the profile of the wheel and I revolved it around the central axis. This way I had a surface on which I could project the offsetted sketch. This is how I managed to create that path. So I end up with a 3D sketch. Starting from there, it's the same process that I used for the previous import. Load curves, select the curves, select the faces, and done. Okay, now I can rotate my path frame if needed, modify the approach and retract movements, update, and simulate. This looks pretty good. Now the path considers the size of the cutting tool. I can launch the main program and see the result. Okay, now we can select the main program and press F6. That will generate the text file that can be sent to the robot. All these lines are the targets to reach. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I really hope you have learned a few things. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are releasing a lot of new tutorial videos to help you guys get up to speed with RoboDK. You can always leave a comment in the comments section below if you want us to address a specific topic. And don't forget our forum. It's the best place to ask your technical questions. Have a good day, guys.